Hello, hello, hello. Hi again, everyone, and welcome back to me punching an inanimate object for 10 minutes straight, part 73. Do y'all like my hat? I really think it brings out the fake piece of shit inside of me. As you can see, we're back in the usual recording space after taking a slight detour to punch Slazzo in his stupid hamburger-loving face. And to celebrate our return home, I wanted to talk to you all about some epic James Charles news. Something you all likely already heard about. Whether it was through Twitter, Phil DeFranco, or iNabber somehow uploading a VHS filter lyric video on it before it even became a trend. Whatever cursed means you came across it by, the beauty YouTuber uploaded a video yesterday where he announced his 24-city tour, the Sisters Tour, where he reveals to all of those in attendance that they are actually all biologically related to him and to each other. But the massive outrage that came about from that chicken casserole disaster came not from the fact that the tour existed, but rather the original pricing for the different ticket tiers, of which there were four. As I'm listing these, bear in mind that the prices I'm saying are before both the taxes and venue fees for specific locations. The first tier was general admission, projected to be around $60 per person. There was the VIP tier, which was about $100 and included preferred seating with lower priority than the higher ticket tiers, early access to merchandise vendors, and a tour laminate which James Charles would exclusively be signing by farting on it. VIP Plus was $250. With it, you got the methane-signed tour poster, the early access to merch, as well as guaranteed front seats behind the highest ticket package tier. You also got a one-on-one photo with James Charles and a premium VIP goodie bag. And lastly was VIP Plus, which was a bone-shattering $500. With this 10-inch dick-sized package, you get the photo with James, the merch vendor early access, the poop-signed tour laminate, guaranteed front seats, a sister's VIP goodie bag with different stuff than the VIP Plus bag, and an exclusive hangout with James Charles and whoever else had the balls big enough to buy the same ticket tier as you. Now, if those prices sounded rather, large to you, don't worry, you very clearly were not alone. You see, Twitter was having some absolute words with James Charles over this. James Charles has the audacity to charge $250 to $500 for VIP tickets? Which you know his 10 to 15 year old fans can't afford on their own. Kinda gross in my opinion, sister extortion. The way James Charles is charging $500 for a VIP ticket knowing full well that the majority of his fans aren't going to be able to afford it on their own, but that his young impressionable fans will still be whipped enough to break their bank accounts just for a hangout with him. Real quick, I gotta say one thing to this bitch who used the surgical mask emoji at the end of her tweet. That's my emoji, bitch. It's not yours to use. Now, all of this got on James's radar, as it inevitably would've. You literally couldn't look anywhere without seeing something about an epic style, and he took to Twitter to respond to the initial backlash. While the tweets have been since deleted, it was essentially just him saying that he understands the outrage, but in order to shoulder a tour like this with big venues and a big staff, there are a lot of people that need to get paid. And in addition to that, that meeting everybody who turns up to the event is physically impossible. And at the end of the day, even if he is personally doing this for fun and as a thank you, it's run by a business that needs to turn a profit. But he also said that he was still trying to lower the ticket prices to be as affordable as possible. After that, we finally got our revamped tour ticket tiers from James. And before the list of what was included in those tiers, we had this prefacing it. VIP tier tickets will be extremely limited per show. Over 85% of tickets available are general admission. There will be ticket giveaways on our social platforms in the next few weeks leading up to the start of the tour. The prices above reflect our prices. Side note, but I'm really sorry to break this to you, James, but the prices are actually listed below that description. You heard it here first, lads. James Charles is suffering from early onset dementia and is not fit to run for president. If a higher price is listed on a venue's website, that reflects that specific venue's added service fees or tax, which we are not in control of. Any policies in regards to infants or phones also reflect the policy set in place by those specific venues. They are not our rules. I have no problems with phones at all, and my team is working on making sure phone usage is not restricted. I look forward to seeing and meeting many of you on the road, and please reach out with any questions. General admission is listed at $52.50, and it's still just a seated ticket at the show, where 20 random ones will be upgraded to a meet and greet ticket on the day of. The real difference obviously would come in the VIP tiers, which is where the controversy initially started. And the biggest difference is that across all of the tiers, they have been beefed up so that you were getting way more bang for your buck. The $100 VIP tier for before now gets you the post-show meet and greet that was originally only in the $500 tier. The VIP Plus $250 tier now gets you a chance to be brought on stage for interactive parts of the show. And the value of the goodie bag included with a ticket is now listed, being roughly $100 plus according to this document itself. And lastly, the jaw-dropping, god-smiting sister VIP $500 tier ticket gets you both a pre-show catered private hangout Q&A with James as well as the the post show one, a $250 plus valued goodie bag, the chance to be brought up for interactive segments, and having your eyes being brutally gouged out by James himself. Now, these tiers are clearly a lot more for the dollar than you were getting before. Stuff that was exclusive to the $500 tier is now available for the $100 one. But as a result of it being more affordable, they've probably slimmed down the availability of any variant of VIP ticket by quite a bit. As James said in the post, over 85% of tickets will be general admission, leaving 50% for the other three tiers of tickets, with the amount of tickets being less and less the more expensive the tier is. And this makes sense, and it was probably still like that before he had revamped the tiers, but in order to handle a new influx of people that James will have to meet now, they might have lowered the ceiling of available tickets to purchase per tier even more.
And considering how few of these VIP tickets are available, when people say he's scamming his fans to make a profit by charging this much, they overestimate just how many fans are going to even be able to get their hands on these tickets. Part of their price comes from their exclusivity.
In regards to James's initial explanation for and reaction to this whole thing, though, a fair amount of people weren't really happy with it, this being before he announced the revamped ticket tiers. A lot of them cited other YouTubers who were able to do tours like this one, but were charging significantly less than James. The one I saw the most was Colleen Bollinger, aka Miranda Sings. God, I hope I said either of those names right, where general admission was apparently $40 and VIP meet and greet was $80. And while the new pricing scale for James's tour is much more akin to that, where general admission is $50 and the VIP meet and greet is included in the $99 package, the demand for the tour itself really isn't comparable at all. And I don't mean what I'm about to say as an attack on Colleen or anything like that. The same kind of thing would apply even more if someone like me were to start a tour. It's more to just try and put things in perspective. But even at the peak of Colleen's career, she was nowhere near the level of fame that James has managed to reach right now. Right now, she is at 8 million subscribers throughout the whole of her career, which is undeniably impressive. But James has done those numbers in an exponentially shorter amount of time. Not to mention he's still growing incredibly fast, and he appears to have a significantly more dedicated audience than Colleen. Like, this guy gridlocks entire fucking cities when he visits them just to open Morphe stores. The demand to meet with him is incredibly, almost unprecedentedly high. And that's really what it comes down to, supply and demand. When so many people want to meet one singular person, in this case James Charles, him and his team valuing a chance to meet him that high isn't that far-fetched. As a side note, it does kind of suck that James likely wasn't even the one to entirely think of these prices on his own, as he's never ran a tour before, from my understanding, and it's more likely that the company running it suggested these prices to him, and now he's the one taking all the grenade shrapnel now that the thing has blown up, because he's the face of the whole damn thing. But that aside, as he said in the ticket pricing preface, even if not referring to the same thing, these are just his team's prices. This is the worth him and his team have assigned to these things. A person is free to determine if the price of a ticket they're buying is worth the service they are getting in return. And in the case of something like this, it's very much a luxury purchase where you are buying a ticket to something purely for pleasure reasons. And if you don't think that the pleasure that you would be getting out of it is worth what you would be spending on the ticket, then don't buy it. That is your choice. You could argue that because his fans are young and likely impressionable, that they wouldn't be able to afford the tickets, which sucks. But James Charles' time isn't inherently owed to anybody. And this is a transaction at the end of the day, not something that James owes his fans inherently. Or maybe it's you think that his audience isn't mature enough to be able to make that kind of decision with their money on their own. And maybe you're right, but at that same age where they're not going to be able to maturely make that decision, and like it's been argued before, they also probably wouldn't be able to afford to buy the ticket on their own. So somebody who can't afford it would have to buy it for them, that person likely being an adult, and then it would be up to said adult's discretion as to whether or not the tickets they are buying are worth what they are meant to be getting in return. Whether that's them directly getting joy from going to the James Charles thing, or whether it's joy by proxy of seeing the person they bought the tickets for enjoying themselves at the event themselves. To me, it's just another case of people getting up in arms about how other people choose how they spend their money. Like, James and his team are telling you exactly what you are getting for what you are paying, and if you get what you were told you were getting, then it's not a scam because you have all the tools in front of you to determine if it was worth it. No one is being forced to buy things, and you are being told exactly what you're getting. And hey, if it really is the case that the meeting really isn't worth that much, then James's tour will fucking flop.
But looking at how the ticket sales are going at the moment, it does not appear to be the case.
Parallel to that, though, I've seen a lot of people saying something along the lines of James Charles is childish for blocking people who mention stuff about the tickets, like in a negative light about him, and that he's just not taking criticism because he's not good at responding stuff to like this, which I personally think is dumb, because he's already rectified the tiers to be a lot closer to the pay scales of other YouTuber tours he's constantly had cited at him. And also, just because he blocks people who keep tweeting at him about it doesn't mean he hasn't seen the criticism already. I mean, he has already openly addressed it. Seeing the same thing over and over again isn't gonna make the same thing any any different than it was the last 7,000 times. But on him deleting some of his earlier tweets though, this is what he had to say. Because I'm talking to my team about ticket prices and wasn't in the mood to read negativity and rude comments. No, not including constructive criticism when I'm already dealing with a lot. And to end this video off, I want to quote something my friend Diesel said in regards to this whole situation on Twitter, where he basically said that James needs to be less shameful and apologize a lot less. Because a lot of people will just take that as an admission of guilt and just fucking run with it. As he put it, people want outrage, not change. Alright, I'm done trying to pretend that I'm really profound and smart. It's outro time. I'm gonna wrap this video up here. If you guys enjoyed, be sure to drop a like, and if you're new, subscribe. Some of you guys may have noticed that the quiteshop.com is no longer up. Merch production is gonna be halted at the moment while I try and figure some stuff out. Just be on the lookout because some stuff is coming in the future. But yeah, no merch at the moment. Sorry if you were looking to purchase some. I'm not really happy with the standard of quality at the moment. But as usual, if you want to go and check out my streams, you can go to twitch.tv/quite. I have a podcast with Wild Spartans and FPS Diesel called Loudmouse. We upload one new episode every week on Saturdays, and we're up on iTunes, SoundCloud, YouTube, and Spotify. You can follow me on Twitter at quite and on Instagram at quite.png. Links to both of those in the description below. And lastly, I also got that Discord server. Link to that description as well if you're interested. Anyways, this has been quite, and I'll see you guys next time. Quite. This hat look is fresh as shit, dude.